It's Friday, 5:30 p.m. here in Singapore, and you're watching The Big Story, where we'll discuss the top news of the day and explain why it matters. I'm Haryanto Diman, reporting to you live from the Straits Times newsroom. Singaporeans who shop in Malaysia, besides credit cards and other cashless payments, you can now use your NETS ATM cards at various locations. More than 7,400 NETS payment points are now active across tourist and retail hotspots in Johor Bahru, Malacca, Kuala Lumpur and Penang. When NETS and its Malaysian counterpart PayNet piloted the project last November, they started with 4,500 points in Johor Bahru. NETS says that payments will not incur any currency conversion fees and users will enjoy competitive exchange rates. Now, to tell us more, we have journalist Lester Wong. Welcome, Lester.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Thank you. Now, Lester, there are so many different modes of cashless payment nowadays. Mm-hmm. You know, we have debit and credit cards, not to mention even QR codes, like you have your GrabPay, Alipay, and there is Apple Pay as well, you know. How does NETS compare with these other modes of payments? You know, why would shoppers still choose to use NETS?
So I think the biggest upshot of NETS' new cross-border payment service is that there are a lot of Singaporeans with a NETS card, probably more so than people with a certain amount of credit cards or debit cards. So I think, as you just said, the cashless payment landscape is notoriously fragmented.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's just going to be the case that there are going to be a lot more people with a NETS debit card than there are for any given Alipay or GrabPay or Apple Pay.
Yeah. And why then would shoppers choose to still go with NETS?
So NETS has promised that they're going to offer a rather competitive exchange rate.
Okay.
But I think as far as shoppers go, I mean, the easiest way is for you to go and find out for yourself. So just go to somewhere in Malaysia, try out a NETS payment point. Because it's mandatory in Malaysia that for all transactions with using Forex currency, the exchange rate has to be printed on the receipt. So, I mean, that's the easiest way for you to find out.
Right, so to experience it for yourself, right? You know, for the benefit of our viewers, of course, who are watching, what are some of the popular shops or malls that they can use NETS at? And also, are there any plans to roll out to other places as well?
So there are currently 7,400 NETS acceptance points in Malaysia. So this is up from 4,500 that was announced last year that was restricted to JB. So now the points are in Penang, they're in KL, and they're also in Malacca. Yeah. So there are popular shopping malls like Makota Parade in Malacca, Sunway Pyramid in KL, as well as KL International Airport, and Queen's Bay Shopping Mall in Penang. So these are all, as I understand them, pretty big and popular shopping spots.
Right. And I understand that it's going to be rolled out in Thailand as well, as early as next year.
This one is a separate initiative. So this one is for QR payments, and it could be expected as a early as sometime next year in Thailand.
Okay.
And after that, I mean, NETS plan is to expand further into the region.
Into the region, okay. Now, when it comes to overseas transactions, I think many are concerned with card security, you know. So how's NETS doing in this department?
So I don't have that many details about this. I mean, all NETS told me is that they're investing significantly into security. I mean, it is a paramount concern for most consumers and for payment providers these days. But obviously, you have to pay a premium for good security, and that's the balance that NETS they need to straddle, because I mean, you want to keep your payment service affordable and convenient as well.
Yeah. Now, thank you, Lester, again for sharing more on this. Now, to read more, you can visit our website at straitstimes.com.